ladybug. Bet I can see it closer with this. Guys? Never mind. Everything is okay.
But God proves His own love for us, and now while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. But God. Welcome everyone to another lesson in Gospel Journey. We started a new unit last week, and we are in the New Testament. So, I have a question for you, Janie. Have you ever been really thirsty? Yes. Maybe you were outside on a hot day, or you just ran a lot. What did you do?
You go get water when you're thirsty.
When you're a kid in the neighborhood, what do you do?
I don't know. I guess you go to wherever, a hose. Or
you go to a hose. You go to your neighbor's hose. You don't go to the house. You say, hey, can I get a drink out of your water hose?
I don't know if they do that anymore.
That's what I did. Did you? Yeah. Okay. Were you thirsty again later?
Yeah, because you're playing and, you know, you're sweating or whatever, working, and it's kind of like you just... Nowadays, people are a lot smarter and they have their little water.
I know. Carry water with them all the time.
Yeah, my granddaughter has her water bottle with her, and I should do that too, but I don't. So
I know.
I always think she's a little bit smarter than I am.
That's cute.
Okay, well, our activity, today's lesson is, there's my pencil right there, about Jesus talking to the woman at the well. So here is our older kids activity page. It's called Get to the Well. So basically, here's the start. You got to get to the well over here. Let's see. Complete the maze by finding the correct path from Jesus to the Samaritan woman at the well. I would start here, personally. Okay. Living water. Jesus told the Samaritan at the well that whoever drinks from the water he gives will never be thirsty again. Use a blue crayon to color in the picture that describe truths about the living water Jesus gives. Okay, that's good. Then our younger kids. Okay. Cross out the first word and then every other word on the well, and use the remaining words to finish the sentence. So cross out them. First words, you can cross this one out. What?
And then every other word after that, or?
I guess that's just a rock in the wall. Every other word, okay, so you're not a space. Cross this one out, keep that one. Cross that one out, keep that one. Cross that one out, keep that one. About like that, okay? Right. Called Never Thirsty. All right. Do you think this pitcher of water is enough to fill all of these glasses of water? Okay.
I don't.
And if this isn't working, we're going to stop and do it again. Okay, so this water couldn't fill up all 10ths of them, all four of these. So if we had four really thirsty kids here, we wouldn't be able to give them a full cup of water. So sometimes we try to fill our lives up with things that never fill us or leave us satisfied. Unlike this demonstration, there is someone who promises that if we drink the water that he gives, we'll never be thirsty again. So let's look at our Bible story. Wait, in just a minute. Not yet. We're going to look at our Bible story in just a minute. Before we do that, our big picture question is, last week we learned our big picture question. It is, how do we know God loves us? We can know that God loves us because he gave us Jesus to forgive the sins of the world. Not just us, but the whole world. All right, so... how do we know that God loves us? God's love is so great that he was willing to give us his only son so that we could be saved. And God's love is available to everyone. No matter where you live or what you do or what you have done, in today's Bible story, we can see how God loved a woman from Samaria who was looked down by others. Okay? Jesus came to the woman and offered her forgiveness. So last week, we talked about Jesus talking to Nicodemus. The week before that, we learned that Jesus came to be the sacrifice for sin. The week before that, he called his disciples. So we're talking about the ministry of Jesus in the early part of the New Testament, because we're going through the Bible from Genesis all the way to Revelation. So today's lesson is in let me see where the book of the Bible is. Probably still in Matthew. Nope, John 4. So today's lesson comes from John 4. Let's watch our video.
Jesus had been teaching in Judea. He and his disciples began traveling back to Galilee. They traveled through Samaria and stopped in a town with a well. Jesus' disciples went into town to buy food. When Jesus was at the well, a Samaritan woman came to get water from the well. Jesus said to her, "Give me a drink." The woman was surprised. "Why are you talking to me?" she asked. "You're a Jew and I'm a Samaritan." Jesus said, "I asked you for a drink. You don't know who I am. If you did, you would have asked me for a drink, and I would give you living water." The woman was confused. She said, "Sir, this well is deep, and you don't have a bucket. Where do you get this living water?" Jesus said, "Anyone who drinks this well water will be thirsty again, but whoever drinks from the water I give will never be thirsty again. In fact, the water I give will become a well inside you, and you will have eternal life." Jesus was talking about the Holy Spirit, but the woman did not understand. "Sir," she said, "give me this water. If I'm not thirsty, I won't have to keep coming to this well to get water." "Go get your husband," Jesus said. "I don't have a husband," the woman replied. Jesus knew she was telling the truth. He said, "You don't have a husband now, but you've had five husbands." Jesus was right. "I see you are a prophet," the woman said. Maybe this prophet could explain something to her. She said, "The Samaritans worship here on a mountain, but the Jews say we need to worship at the temple in Jerusalem." Jesus said, "Soon you will not need to be in either of those places to worship God in spirit and in truth." The woman said, "I know the Messiah is coming. When he comes, he will explain everything to us." Then Jesus said, "I am the Messiah." The woman left and told the people in her town, "Come, see a man who told me everything I ever did. Could this be the Messiah?" Many Samaritans believed in Jesus because of what the woman said. Jesus stayed in their town for 2 days. Many more believed because of what Jesus said. They told the woman, "We no longer believe because of what you said, for we have heard for ourselves and know that this is really the Savior of the world." Jesus offers something better than physical water. He gives us himself. Jesus gives the Holy Spirit to everyone who comes to him by faith. We can worship him as Lord and Savior wherever we are.
I don't know if he reviews the Bible story, but we're going to review it again. Besides, you need to be listening so you can answer questions. Jesus purposely went through the region of Samaria on his way back to Galilee. God loves all people and sent Jesus to save everyone who believes in him, even the woman of Samaria, who was not popular. When Jesus asked the woman for water, she was surprised. Usually Jews and Samaritans avoided one another, but Jesus loved this woman and wanted her to know the truth of the gospel. He told the woman that he would give her water that was living. But she was confused that once again, Jesus is responding in a way that is confusing to people because he had no way to draw water from the well. What did Jesus mean by this? Well, when we believe in Jesus, he gives us his spirit. And while we need water to live, we have a much deeper thirst than simple physical water. Jesus wanted the woman to know that his spirit could satisfy her heart and that in him, she would have all that she needed. So, how did Jesus help the woman understand this, that her heart was not satisfied? So let's look at John 4, 16 through 18, all right? Jesus said to her, "Go call your husband and come here." And the woman answered him, "I have no husband." Jesus said to her, "You are right in saying I have no husband, for you have had five husbands, and the one you now have is not your husband. What you have said is true." What? The Samaritan woman had sinful relationships that left her broken. But through Jesus, she could be made whole and happy in him. He also reminded the woman that when we believe in him, he gives his Holy Spirit so that we can worship him anywhere. And what did Jesus say the Holy Spirit will help us do? So we find the answer in John 4, 23 through 24. But hour is coming and is now here when true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and truth, for the Father is seeking such people to worship him. God is spirit, and those who worship him must worship in spirit and truth. So the Holy Spirit lives inside of us and guides us into the truth so that we can worship God rightly. The woman then went and told everyone all Jesus had said, and many believed because of her testimony, and even more believed when they spoke to Jesus for themselves. All right, so Jesus offers us something better than physical water. He gives himself. Jesus gives the Holy Spirit to everyone who comes to him by faith, and we can worship him as Lord and Savior wherever we are. All right. It's time for questions from kids. Pastor Kevin, what should we do when we worry how others will react to our sinful behavior? How does God's Spirit help us live differently? Let's watch the video.
Hi there, I'm Pastor Kevin. It's time for questions from kids. Lisa from Virginia Beach, Virginia asks,
I got in trouble at school. Now I'm afraid everyone will think I'm a bad kid. What should I do?
Oh, that's a really thoughtful question. I remember getting in trouble at school and being concerned about the same thing. My teacher and my friends are gonna think I'm a bad person. Oh, and that did bother me so much. I do want you to seek forgiveness from the teacher or your friend or whoever you may have hurt or offended. I also want you to ask the Lord to forgive you. So forgiveness is both with the people that we have offended and also with the God of heaven that we could have offended. You know, fear not. Everyone is a sinner. Everyone in your school, in your home, and in your church has done something bad or sinful before. Some things we see with our eyes, and then some things are just a matter of the heart that we really can't see with our eyes. Do try to avoid doing the same things again. If you think you're going to be tempted to do the same thing again, you have to remember, no, that was wrong and sinful last time, and I need to try not to do that thing again. Also remember that God gives us a way out. The scripture tells us he always gives us a way out. He has also given us the power of his Holy Spirit to prompt us and to remind us of what the wrong thing is, as well as what the right and godly thing is. How does God's Spirit help you to live differently?
Time for our missions moment now. Pastors and their wives from Florida and Louisiana went to help missionaries in Southern Europe. While they were there, they met with a Brazilian pastor who leads a church in Spain. Another Hispanic missionary couple serving in Spain is Gabriel and Camilla Santiago. They have built friendships with some Muslim people in Spain through teaching language classes and sponsoring a sports ministry. These ministries help the Santiagos tell people about Jesus. Many of the Muslim people greet Gabriel as a friend. They trust him and know that he is an immigrant living in a different place, just as they are. Let's see, now we have a missions video.
Louita Reyes and her husband are members of Neptune Baptist Church, which is in Neptune Beach near Jacksonville, Florida. Louita and her husband traveled with a group of Hispanic missionaries from Florida and Louisiana to serve in Europe. The missionaries did evangelistic work in the city market, where they passed out the Gospel of John in Spanish and in Arabic. Some people gladly took the books, but many said no. Louita says, the challenge that I take with me is that even though they reject the gospel, even though they tell us no, they need to hear the love of God. They need to hear from Jesus. Pray that God will bring more people to help the missionaries trying to bring the gospel to these people in need.
Welcome back from the missions video, and it's time for our key passage. Okay? God loves us so much that he sent his son, Jesus, to die for us. And we can know with confidence that God loves us because of what Jesus has done for us. So, our verse for this unit is Romans 5:8. But God shows his love for us in while we're still sinners, Christ died for us. But God shows his love for us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Romans 5:8. And the song for this unit is His Own Love. Okay. Well, thank you for being with us today. Hope you learned a lot and that you understand the gospel. That's why we do this, is so that you understand all that Jesus has done for you because he loves you. Let's pray. Thank you, God, that you sent Jesus to die for us and show us your love. Thank you for giving Jesus to satisfy our hearts and give us eternal life. Help us to share Jesus with others. Amen. See you next time.